Hi, I'm Tom Collins. I'm the Executive Director of the Arizona Citizens Clean Elections Commission. I'd like to introduce Luigi Del Puerto. He's the publisher of the Arizona Capital Times. The Capital Times is partnering with the Commission and will be moderating the debates in some of these very important legislative districts. It's an exciting time at the Commission because every 2 years, the Commission sponsors debates for legislative and statewide candidates around the state. That gives you, the voter, the opportunity to engage directly with the candidates by attending the debates, watching the debates online, and submitting questions for the candidates either at the debates or via our website. It's also exciting because, this is a very important political year, as all are, so you need to know that by July 30th, if you haven't registered to vote, you gotta. And if you want to vote early, you need to request an early ballot by August 17th. And also, perhaps most importantly, Arizona allows independents to vote in partisan primaries. So if you're an independent and you want to vote in the Republican primary, you can. And if you're a Democrat and you want to vote in the or if you're an independent and you want to vote in the Democratic primary, you can do that also. So you just have to pick a ballot. So today we're going to talk a little bit about District 20, which is a West Phoenix district. Luigi, what do we know about District 20?
District 20. Is a very conservative district, has always performed Republican. It has sent consistently Republican elected officials to the state Senate and to the state House. But something happened this year that made Democrats feel this may be a good year for them to try and field candidates in this district and maybe one seat, or maybe win one seat. So as you know, we recently had a special election in Congressional District 8, and in that congressional district, part of that congressional district is LD20. And in LD20, what happened was that the Democrat candidate for the special election in Congress won the district's votes, which was very surprising. You're talking about 10,000 votes or so, and it was a very good, if you're talking about polling, for example, that was a very good sample size. And that made a lot of people rethink what might happen to LD20, which, as I'd mentioned, has consistently elected Republicans for the two House seats and the state Senate. And so now the Democrats are fielding a full slate. I mean, they have in past years, but they're thinking, well, maybe this is the year that we can win a seat in this district. And if the results of the special congressional election were to be a guide, then maybe they have a chance in this traditionally very conservative Republican district.
Well, you know, the other thing that's interesting looking at this is, now we're expecting at our debate the majority of the candidates to be there. You've got Democrats who are all competing with each other for two nominations for the House. You have Democrats who are competing for one nomination for the Senate. You have Republicans there's an open Senate seat, so you have Republicans competing for the Senate nomination. So that's a whole heck of a lot of people all trying to run. You don't see that in every district. I mean, where you have an open seat in the Senate, you have one open seat in the House, and a lot of people are rushing in to try to take an opportunity there.
So you're absolutely right. It's not very typical for both parties to be fielding so many candidates in a district like LD20, especially if you have incumbents either from the House trying to get into the Senate. But LD20 is one of those districts that has always attracted a lot of people. The bench is just deep in this district, especially on the Republican side. This is a district that we have seen all sorts of candidates, and we always attract many candidates, especially Republicans, every single year. And it's one of those districts where the what we like to describe as the inter-party infighting, if you will, within the Republican Party is quite prominent. And so you see that in the primary races.
So that's an important point. And so it's an opportunity through the clean elections debates and the debate that Luigi and his colleagues be moderating for you to make sure that as a voter, you're hearing from the candidates about your issues. You know, there's partisan stuff and there's a lot. It's a very interesting district, but the opportunity is there for you to ask questions through our website or at the debate itself to make sure that your issue is getting addressed by the candidates who are running. So you can log on to azcleanelections.gov to find the place and time of this debate and all of our debates, to suggest questions for Luigi and his colleagues to ask, and finally to come back if you can't make it to the debate to watch the video of the debate. So azcleanelections.gov will have all the information to both prepare you and inform you to cast your ballot in the August primary.